Welcome back to Demystifying Medicine. In today's video, we will be discussing Alzheimer's disease. Wait, what is it again? Did you know that memory actually involves forgetting? Every day we are exposed to millions of stimuli that get processed by our brain. And each time, only selected stimuli are processed and encoded into our long-term memory. Whatever doesn't make the cut gets forgotten. As we age, we naturally start to forget things more easily, and this is normal. However, there are some of us who may experience something that is beyond normal memory loss, such as Alzheimer's disease or other forms of dementia. Please take a moment to read the list to differentiate between normal aging and Alzheimer's disease. At this point, you must be wondering, what is Alzheimer's? Is it the same thing as dementia? And how do I know if I have it? Well, Alzheimer's is defined as an irreversible neurodegenerative brain disorder that leads to the progressive loss of brain cells, also known as neurons. Neurons are needed to receive and transmit information within the brain. So when the connections between them are destroyed, normal functioning within the brain becomes disrupted, resulting in dementia. Dementia is an umbrella term used to describe a set of symptoms that are associated with the decline of cognitive abilities, such as memory loss and thinking skills. Dementia affects the daily lives of more than 500,000 Canadian seniors, with Alzheimer's being the most common cause. Alzheimer's can start at different stages in life, characterized as late onset or early onset. Late onset is typically the sporadic form and starts in individuals who are in their mid-60s. Early onset describes the start of Alzheimer's in individuals in their 30s to mid-60s and is commonly familial. There are two forms of Alzheimer's, sporadic and familial. The majority of cases are sporadic, meaning no one knows how the disease arises. The second type is familial and is a rarer form of Alzheimer's. It arises due to a mutation in a gene that is inherited from a parent. These mutations commonly occur in three major genes: the amyloid precursor protein gene, penicillin 1 gene, and penicillin 2 gene. At the cellular level, there are two proteins that are believed to be involved in the progression of Alzheimer's: beta amyloid and tau proteins. Inside the neurons, tau starts to build up in an abnormal amount, forming tangles, while between the neurons, beta amyloid proteins start to clump up to form plaques. The continuous development of these tangles and plaques eventually leads to the deterioration of brain cells and loss of synaptic connections. With the continuous death of cells, the brain starts to shrink, especially in the hippocampus. The hippocampus is a structure of the brain that is crucial for long-term memory. The destruction of this structure will result in memory loss and cognitive decline of a patient with Alzheimer's disease. Beyond the neural level, there are environmental factors that may indirectly contribute to Alzheimer's, such as repeated exposure to lead. Lifestyle choices may also indirectly contribute to Alzheimer's, such as an unhealthy diet, sedentary behavior, and repeated exposure to stress, among other factors. As mentioned earlier, symptoms of Alzheimer's include dementia, although more elaborately, they may involve problems with language, visual, and spatial skills, as well as impaired reasoning or judgment. These issues prevent individuals diagnosed with Alzheimer's from performing normal activities in their everyday life. On top of these difficulties, patients with Alzheimer's are also negatively affected by the stigma surrounding the disorder. Within society, there are many people who believe that individuals with Alzheimer's are useless and dependent. While their conditions compel them to require more assistance, they are not incompetent. They are still functioning members of our society. While Alzheimer's is irreversible, meaning there is currently no cure available, there are tests that can diagnose the disease in its early stages. Currently, some of the standard tests performed are MRI or CT scans, among others. But according to recent studies, a retinal scan is currently being studied to determine its accuracy in detecting Alzheimer's in its early stages. This test involves the retina because it gives us the opportunity to explore non-invasive biomarkers for dementia and Alzheimer's disease. In this case, biomarkers can include different cells, structures, and any retinal changes that have occurred. Detection of these biomarkers would lead to early diagnosis for patients with Alzheimer's. Although evidence is accumulating in support of Alzheimer's disease-related changes in the retina, further studies are required to confirm this new diagnostic method. It is important to undergo testing if you suspect yourself or someone of having Alzheimer's, because while there is no cure, there are certain interventions that may reduce the risk and severity of the disease. If Alzheimer's is diagnosed early enough, the progression of the disease can be slowed down by taking medication, such as acetylcholine esterase inhibitors. Such medications work to decrease the symptoms of Alzheimer's by improving communication between nerve cells. While there is no way to prevent Alzheimer's, it is recommended to incorporate physical activity into your everyday life and maintain a well-balanced diet. If you suspect someone of having Alzheimer's, recommend them to see a doctor and discuss their options. For individuals and families living with dementia, here is a list of a few resources that offer support.
See you next week, and take care of your health.